Hello friends, welcome to our channel. In this lecture, I would like to explain another example based on the stiffness matrix method. See the question here. Example 4. Using displacement method, analyze the given beam. If support B sinks by 10 mm, as shown in the figure, take EI equal to 6000 kN meter square. So already in the last three examples, I explained based on the continuous beams. For example, if you see here, this model. So here our basic unknowns, that is our basic displacements, unknown displacements are 2, that is at B and C. Therefore, this matrix comes under the 2 by 2 stiffness matrices. Here we solved based on the 2 by 2 matrices. At the same time, there will be no external forces in this problem. For that purpose, I made another video, that is in example 2. This is 3 by 3 stiffness matrix, because here our unknown displacements are at B, C, D, because here degree of freedom will be equal to 3. Based on that, our unknown displacements will be 3. At the same time, here what about this P1, P2, P3? Here P1 and P3 will be the moments whatever obtained at their edges. So I explained very clearly in this example. At the same time, in the third example, if you observe, means one simple frame. So in the last two problems, at a single joint, the two connecting members, that is one BA and BC like that. At C, some BC and some CB and CD like that. But here, while solving the stiffness matrices, you have to consider K11 equal to 4AI by its length of the BC plus its length of the BD plus its length of the BA. Like that, you have to add three moments in the three spans. So you will get some variation comparing to other three models. That is the reason for that. Model purpose only, I am selecting this one, and I explained very clearly in what way you have to solve the stiffness matrices method in such type of examples are given in the question. All these three remains a very similar procedure, just based on the 2 by 2 matrices, 3 by 3 matrices. At the same time, on a single joint, if two members are connected and if three members are connected, what is the variation? I showed small variation in these three examples. At the same time, if you coming to this problem, sinking of the supports, here also in the sinking of the supports, entire problems remain same, just we have to consider additional moments what are developed based on the sinking of the supports. For that also, there will be various types of cases are there. For example, in our question, support B sinks by 10 mm will be given. So generally in the semester examination, there is a chances of asking if support B only sinks by some particular mm. At the same time, both supports B and C will be sinks by some 5 mm and some 10 mm. So here loading conditions are not mentioned. So in some cases, in some semester examination, there is a chances of asking if given loading conditions are there. For example, a point load is given on span AB. So what are the additional moments developed along with the given fixed end moments? See here, what I am telling means, here in this case, so this is the first case. If only support B sinks, what are the additional moments developed? At the same time, if both the supports B and C will be sinks, what are the additional moments developed? At the same time, if loading conditions are given at some point load, some eccentric load or some UDL along with the sinking of the supports, in what way we have to consider additional moments along with the given loading conditions? Like that, I explained very, very clearly in the last lecture itself, and I gave that link in the description also. Friends, if you go and watch that video, means you will know that in what are the nature of the fixed moments. Why I am taking here negative moment and why I am taking here positive moments. So that is the nature of the fixed end moments. At the same time, here I am taking some value. So the moment value will be equal to 6EI delta by L square. Generally, this can be obtained by deriving the fixed end moments at a different level. See here. So both are at different levels. So see, this is the level of the beam, original position of the beam. But while deriving these fixed end moments at different levels, you will get this constant value. So you don't need to derive entire problem here. You just remember the value. Whenever sinking of the support is given, your unit value will be equal to 6EI delta by L square. So like that, each and every terminology I explained very clearly in the last lectures itself. I gave each and every link in the description. You please go and watch that video. This example also very, very easy to understand. Then move to the problem. Then move to the problem. See here, our first step is always used to find the degree of freedom. See here, at A there is fixed end, no degree of freedom. Similarly, at D also there is a fixed end, no degree of freedom. Then what about at B and C? So it is a ruler, therefore you will get only one degree of freedom. That is the reason your total degree of kinematic indebtedness will be equal to 2. Therefore, if our degree of freedom will be equal to 2, means first write down that one. Degree of kinematic indebtedness will be equal to 2. So if your degree of freedom will be equal to 2, means you will get 2 unknown displacements to solve this problem. So that unknown displacements means one at B and another at C. So you select the coordinate positions also at B and C only. Why? Because at A and D it is fixed here. That is the reason you select 2 unknown coordinate position, one at B and another at C. So here delta 1 and here delta 2. Means that is theta 1, here delta 1 will be equal to theta B and delta 2 will be equal to theta C. So whenever your degree of kinematic indebtedness will be equal to 2, means so you will get 2 by 2 matrices to solve this problem. So this is our first step you have to remember. And what about this formula? Delta will be equal to K inverse into P minus PL. So this is the general equation for the 1 by 1 matrix. So if your matrices degree of kinematic indebtedness will be equal to 1, means so you can take direct equation. But here your unknown displacements are 2. So therefore you will get 2 by 2 stiffness matrices to solve this problem. So therefore I am taking this delta as equal to delta 1 and delta 2. Similarly, the stiffness matrices equal to in the form of 2 by 2, that is K11, K12, K21, K22. At the same time, this pressure, these external forces are P1 and P2 and force due to the given loading conditions, that is P1L and P2L. Then see here, I am talking about this diagram. Whenever support B sinks, so I am ABCD is the original level of the beam. If support B sinks, see here, this is the settlement of the beam. So based on the loading condition, B settles to some B dash. At what distance? It will be at a distance of some 10 mm. So A, B dash, C, D is the original settlement of the beam. ABCD is the original level of the beam and A, B dash, CD is the settlement of the beam. Then you can go to the third step. So what are the fixed moments are developed here? I will explain here itself. See here, the nature of the fixed end moments is clockwise at each end when the right support is at a higher level. If you observe this one, means A, B and B dash is at a lower level. If you observe these three, see here, this will be like this. Here it will be A and here it will be B, and A, B are the same level. After settlement, this B settles to some B dash, that is B dash. So what is our note point here? The nature of the fixed end moments is clockwise at each end when the right support is at a higher level. So this is the right support. Similarly, this is the left support. So this right support is at a, sorry, I am talking reverse to this one. So see the second condition. The nature of the fixed end moment is anti-clockwise at each end when the left support is at higher level. This is the left support and this is the right support. So this left support and this one will be the right support. See here, compare A, B dash, settlement of the beam. So this one will be the lower position and this one will be the higher position. Whenever your left support is at higher position, your nature of the fixed end moment is anti-clockwise. See here, I am applying anti-clockwise moment here. Here also I am applying anti-clockwise moment. That anti-clockwise unit moment will be equal to 6EI delta by L square. So already I told you, this can be obtained by deriving the fixed end moments at different levels. So you take down here, that is a constant unit value, 6EI delta by L square. See here, whenever your left support is at higher level, your nature of the fixed end moment will be anti-clockwise both at B and A. That is the reason here I am clearly indicated that this nature of the fixed end moment one will be anti-clockwise here, another at the same time anti-clockwise here also. Then move to the another point. If you see here, the first note point, the nature of the fixed moment is clockwise at each end when the right support is at a higher level. If you see here, B, C, B dash, if you compare here, B dash is at lower level with C. If you compare with C, see here like this. So this is the position of the beam, C, and B dash will be like this. So this is the left level and this one will be the right one. So whenever the nature of the fixed moment is clockwise, at each end when the right support is at higher level. Otherwise you can see this diagram also, this one will be right and this one will be left one. So this is the original level of the beam. B dash is at lower level and right support, that is C, is at higher level. Whenever your right support is at higher level, the nature of the fixed moments will be clockwise only. So that is the reason at both spans BC, I am applying clockwise moment for BC and at the same time clockwise moment for CB also. So this is the nature of the fixed moments. You can take down based on these note points. At the same time, if you observe here one more note point, whenever you can see the moments, some of the moments at a particular joint, for example at B, some of the moments will be BA and BC. If you sum these two, minus 6i delta by L square plus 6i delta by L square, totally you will get zero moments at that position. If you sum those moments, means some of the moments at a particular joints will be equal to zero. So like that you will obtain directly minus 6i delta by L square plus 6i delta by L square at joint C. Okay, this is the condition according to our problem. Then move to the next step. See here. Then our next step is coordinates selected. So already in the starting itself I told you, here our unknown displacements will be equal to, our unknown displacements will be equal to 2. Therefore I am selecting 2 coordinate position. But you see here at A and D it is fixed, there is no chances of selecting coordinate position. That is the reason I am selecting one coordinate position at B, another coordinate position at C. Therefore our coordinate positions is at B and C. So here it will be delta 1 and here it will be delta 2. At the same time delta 1 will be equal to theta B and delta 2 will be equal to theta C. Then move to the next diagram. Fully restrained structure. So what is the meaning of the fully restrained structure? Already I told, I am explaining from the last 3 examples. This step, fully restrained structure, means I am removing the given support conditions. For example, at A it is fixed, at D it is fixed. At B and C it is roller supports. I am removing the given loading condition and I am fixing the entire structure. See here, I am removing the roller here and I am fixing the at B also. I am removing the roller here, I am fixing the C also. Therefore, I am fixing the total entire structure along with the selected coordinate positions. So already selected coordinate positions will be 1 and 2 and I am fixing the total structure. In the next step, what I have to do means, if I want stiffness matrices at first support, means I will only apply moment at here and I fix the entire structure. Similarly, if I want stiffness matrices at second position, means I will fix the entire structure. Then I will remove this fixity. Then I will solve the problem. See here. Here delta 1 and delta 2 are the basic unknown displacements we can be obtained by solving this problem. Okay, then what about this K11, K12, K21, K22? These are the stiffness matrices. It can be developed by solving this problem. And what about this P1 and P2? See here, this P1 and P2. This P1 and P2 are the final forces or the external forces. So see here, in the second example, I explained very clearly what about this P1 and P2. I am removing the given cantilever position and applied movement directly here. Like this, if there will be any such type of movements are there in the problem, your P1 and P2 values can be considered these values, that is 300 kN and 200 kN at selected coordinate positions. At the same time, if any direct movement is applied in the question, means you can consider that also final forces. But here, if you observe our question, is there any such type of final movements are given in the question? So at B and C or at A and D, no, there is no any type such type of direct moments are given in the question. That is the reason your P1 and P2 external forces will be taken as zero. Then based on the restraint structure, I am going for P1L and P2L. So I am showing these two. First step is, so see here, I am finally forces will be P1 and P2. I told you no direct moment is given in the question. That is the reason your P1 and P2 values will be equal to zero. Then move to the fixed end moments. See here, if you see, observe this diagram, what is the procedure for finding fixed moments? For example, fixed moment for AB, What is the general formula? If there is a point load, minus WL by 8. If there is a UDL, minus WL square by 12. If there is an eccentric load, minus WAB square by L square. Like that, for each and every one, there is a standard formula for the fixed moments. But here, there is no loads is given in the question. So, there is no loading conditions. That is, there is no point load, no UDL, no eccentric load. So, if there is no load means, that formula is not there. That is, that one will be 0. But due to the sinking of the supports, some additional moments are developed at this position. So therefore, you please consider that additional moments as your fixed moments. If you see here means, what is the fixed moment at AB? So this anti-clockwise moment, that is minus 6A delta by L square. Due to anti-clockwise reason, so for anti-clockwise, I am taking here negative. For clockwise, always I am taking positive. So due to anti-clockwise, I am taking negative. So therefore, our fixed moment for AB will be equal to minus 6EI delta by L square. In the same way, what is E? So I am taking E like that only. Here I, property is given in the question itself. Wherever I, you please substitute 2I value and delta. So delta will be this one, that is 10 mm. So entire things will be in the meters. That is the reason I am converting this 10 mm in terms of meters. That is 10 divided by 1000. 0, 0 cancel. 1 by 100. That is 0.01 meters. Therefore, I am taking this delta value will be equal to 0.01. At the same time, L square will be equal to 9. Means this 3 square. So length of the span AB will be equal to 3 meters. 3 square will be equal to 9. If you simplify directly by using your calculators, you will get this minus 80 kilonewton meter. So this is the fixed moments. Here there will be no given loading conditions. Therefore, we are considering directly additional moments here. At the same time, what about MBA? So here the nature of the fixed moment for both the spans, that is from AB and from BA, it is anti-clockwise only. Therefore, whatever the moments developed here, the same moments also at this position. Therefore, I am taking minus 6i delta by L square here also. So that is minus 80 kilonewton meter. In the same way, you please observe here. For member BC, there is clockwise 6EI delta by L square. See here, property and length will be different here. Therefore, you please substitute the given values in the span BC. 6 E value. So, due to the clockwise, I am taking positive symbol here. 6 E, wherever I am taking 2.5 I. Because here 2.5 is given in the question itself. At the same time, length delta value will be this 0.01 mm. And this length value, here I am written 16. That is the reason in what way you will get that one. Length of the span BC, that is 4 meters, means 4 square, that is 16. So directly taking all these value, whatever given in the question, and simplify according to our calculators, then you will get this 56.25 kilonewton meter. So whatever the moment developed here in BC, the same moment is there in the CB also. That is clockwise moment. So therefore, both for CB and BC, you will get 56.25 kilonewton meter only. So then what about this fixed moment for CD and DC? There will be no given loading conditions. At the same time, there will be no sinking of the support and in the span CD. Therefore, no additional moments are also developed. That is the reason fixed moment for span CD and DC will be equal to 0 here. That is the reason I am taking 0. Then move to this step, that is P1L and P2L. See here, forces developed in the fully restrained structure. Based on, so what is P1L? So where we are selecting the coordinate position, you have to sum fixed moments. For example, we are selecting coordinate position at B, sum of the fixed moments at the coordinate position 1. So your P1L will be equal to sum of the fixed moments at the coordinate position 1. At the same time, your P2L will be equal to sum of the fixed moments at the coordinate position 2. If you observe here means, what I am telling means, so this is our coordinate selected position. So what about your P1L? Your P1L will be equal to, sorry, this is P1L, not direct external force. So this is P1L. You take them, that one as P1L. Similarly, P2L. So this one will be P1L, this one will be P2L. See here what I am telling, your P1L will be equal to our in our first coordinate position, sum of the movements developed in our first coordinate position. See here, fixed movement for span BA plus fixed movement for span BC. So what is the fixed movement here? For span BA, there will be minus 80 kilonewton meter. Similarly, for span BC, 56.25 kilonewton meter. So if you add these two, what the moment you will get here means minus 23.75 kilonewton meter. That is the reason I am taking minus 23.75 kilonewton meter. At the same time, our second coordinate position is at 2. So our P2L will be based on the second coordinate position. Some of the movements in our coordinate position 2. Some of the fixed movements developed in our coordinate position 2. So MF CB means fixed movement for CB plus fixed movement for CD. So see here, fixed movement for CB will be equal to this 56.25. Fixed movement for CD will be equal to 0. If there will be any movements, for example, if support C also sinks, means you will get one more additional movement at that point. Or else any other loading conditions are given, any UDL is given at that span CD, means you will get some more fixed movements. You can add those two. But here it will be 0. That is the region 56.25 plus 0. That is the region I am indicating directly 56.25 only. And I am taking P2L will be equal to 56.25. Like that, your P1L and P2L forces are developed. See here, your P1, P2 will be 0. P1L and P2L are obtained by using these fixed movements. Friends, up to here only you may confuse in the sinking of the supports. So the general procedure. So for example, if you are going to find the K11, K12, K21, K22, entire procedure as same as the previous problem. If you see the example 1 or else example 2 or else example 3, so entire procedure same as like the continuous beams and frames, non-sway frames only. But here only when sinking of the supports is given, additional moments are only developed. So that is the only point you have to consider in this problem. But I will show you that one also, K11, K12. So in the brief manner, why? Because already I explained three models. If you already know the three models, means this will be very, very simple and easy. See here, in the case one, what I am doing in the case one means I am releasing the structure at B and applying unit moment at B. So I am keeping the same fixity both at C and D, and I am releasing the structure at B and applying the same applying unit moment, that is K11. See here, unit displacement in coordinate direction 1, that is K11. K11 always refers to FD, F for 1 and this F for D, means force in the coordinate direction 1 due to the displacement in the coordinate direction 1 only. Means what is the statement here? I am releasing the structure at B and applying unit moment at B. Then it is K11, and whatever we are selecting coordinate position 2, that one will be K21. See here, what is the moment developed here? K11 equal to 4EI by L for span BC, similarly 4L by LBA for span BA. Similarly, see here one more time I am explaining, K11 will be equal to 4EI by L BC for span BC plus 4EI by LAB for span BA. See here, K11 equal to 4EI by LBA plus 4EI by LBC. So substitute I value what they are given in the question, that is 2i, and length of the span will be 3 meters. Similarly, I value equal to for span BC 2.5i, and length of the span BC will be equal to 4. Then if you simplify that one, directly you will get this value, that is 5.167 EI. Then what about K21? Whatever the movement developed in the span BC, so the exactly half of the movement, that is K21. So K11 equal to 4EI by LBC in the span. So that is, so exactly I am carrying half of the movement in the span BC itself. So here I am carrying exactly this half of the movement. So your K21 will be equal to half of this K11 in the span BC. That is, K21 will be equal to half of the 4EI by LBC, means 2EI by LBC. That is the region 2E, I value will be equal to 2.5I, and L value will be equal to 4 meters. That will be equal to 1.25 EI. So whatever the movement developed K21, the same movement will be for K12 also. So directly you can take down K12 will be equal to 1.25 also. It is very in a easy manner, shortcut manner. Then go to the K22. In the second condition, here I am releasing the structure at C and maintaining fixity both at B, A and D. And I am applying the unit moment at second coordinate position. That one will be equal to k22. What about this 2 and 2? Force due to the second coordinate direction, due to the displacement in the second coordinate direction. So you please remember simply in F and D format. Then other coordinate position will be k12. See here, what is the moment developed here? 4EI by L CD for span CD, 4 plus 4EI by L CB for span CB. See here, 4EI by L CB plus 4EI by L CD. Whatever I value, substitute that one, whatever length, substitute in the same span, and whatever the I value here, both for property will be equal to 2.5 in the span CD, and length value will be equal to 4. If you simplify, directly you will get this one. And what about this K12? So whatever the moment developed in this span, that is 4EI by LBC, whatever the moment developed in this span, exactly carry half of the moment to its other end. Then that is your K12. So your K12 will be equal to whatever the moment developed in this span, you can carry exactly half of the moment to its other end. So don't carry entire value, that is to 5i by equal to half of the moment, means you will get 2.5i. Don't carry entire moment, just carry connecting members. For BC, CB is the connecting member, not CD. That is the reason you just carry half of the moment, whatever developed in the joint C. I am just carrying in the span only. That is half of the moment means 4i by LCB. That one will be equal to half 4i by LCB, simplify 2i by LCB. Substitute the value, you will get there directly 1.25 EI. If you observe this, it means both K21 and K12 will be equal to equal. So after developing the values, obtaining the values, then move to the next step. So this is our formula. So your unknown basics are the displacements. So we are finding this one after substituting all the values. So you know P1, P2 values, P1L, P2L, and K11, K12, K21, K22. So if you simplify directly by using your calculators, don't do a manual procedure in the semester examination. Why? Because it is very, very time taking while doing manually. That is the reason, use your scientific calculators to solve this type of matrices in the examination. So directly we will get this delta 1 delta will be equal to some 7.79 and minus 13.198 EI. So delta 1 will be equal to theta B, delta 2 will be equal to theta C. So you take down according to your convenient. If you are to substitute directly EI theta B, means directly take down this value. So otherwise, if you want to substitute theta B only, means take down 7.79 by EI. So these are the unknown displacements obtained based on this procedure. But if you want to know the final moments also, means see here, already I told you so many times, for solving the final moments, you take down the slope deflection equation, MAB, that one will be equal to MFAB plus 2EI by LAB into 2 theta A plus theta B. So already you people know, see here, take down the given question. See here, both at A and D, it is fixed. Therefore, your slopes at A and D, so theta A and theta will be equal, theta D will be equal to 0. Wherever theta A and theta D, substitute directly. So here also it will be 0. Here also it will be 0. So wherever theta A and theta D, substitute directly, that values will be equal to 0. At the same time, fixed moments for both the spans, CD will be equal to 0 only. Directly I am explaining in a shortcut manner, so entire things will be there. You please directly substitute in the given equations. So you know theta B value and you know theta C value also. See here, this is theta B value 7.79 and theta C value, that is 13.198. At the same time, substitute I value, that is 2i for span AB and 2.5 for span BC and 2.5 for span CD also. At the same time, lengths will be different. For span AB, it will be 3 meters and for span BC, it will be 4 meters and for span CD, it will be 4 meters. Each and every value terminology will be there here. So you please substitute each and every value according to the given conditions in the given formula. Fixed moment for AB will be equal to minus 80. Like that, if you simplify all the values in the equation, means you will get directly fixed moment for AB will be equal to minus 69.613 kilonewton meter. Similarly, for BA, it will be minus 59.227. For similarly, for BC, it will be 59.227 kilonewton meter. And for span CB, final moment will be 33 kilo. Sorry, all these are the final moments, not fixed end moments. Fixed end moments were CD will be equal to 33 kilo Newton meter, and CD will be equal to minus 33 kilo Newton meter, and DC will be equal to minus 16.49 kilo Newton meter. You please check the value once again and take down the obtained values there. At the same time, you observe one more note point here. Some of the moments at a particular joint, at B there will be two spans, that is MBA plus MBC. Therefore, if you sum these two moments, MBA plus MBC, you will get 0 here. So if I am taking some of the moments at a particular joint B, it will be equal to 0. In the same way, some of the moments at a particular joint C, here one more joint, that is at C, if I will sum these two final moments, that is MCB final moment, MCD final moment, it will also will be equal to 0. That is your checkpoint. If you want to check the problem, you take down this condition, some of the moments at a particular joints will be equal to 0, so both the moments here will be 0 only. So this is the procedure for finding final moments also. Friends, I hope you understand this lecture. If you really like this lecture, please like this video, subscribe my channel and share it to your friends. Thank you so much.